Hi guys, in this video, I want to talk to you about one quality that good students have while other students lack that quality. This quality came to my mind very recently due to my interaction with one of the students who was asking me for some help. See, that quality I am talking about is the intent. What is intent? Basically, suppose if I am a good student, okay, or let me start it with the problem that you all guys will be facing. If you are facing it right now, some might be facing it later on. The question that will come to your mind is that we are able to score well in subject wise test, but we are not able to do well in mock test, okay. And the reason for that is in subject test you are tackling only a single subject, while in full length test you are tackling 12 to 15 subjects simultaneously. Definitely the score will drop. And the easy way around it is solving certain test which contains more than one subject but not the 12 subjects. Okay, that is called as a group test in which multiple subjects are being asked simultaneously. Now the solution to this is solving multiple subjects at once. But now, many of you might be thinking, or the question in your mind is that where we will get certain tests, where we will get such tests, who will provide such tests where multiple subjects are being asked in a single test. And that is what exactly I am talking about, is the quality that many good students possess, that they don't rely upon someone to provide them such stuff. Okay, any stuff for that matter. They don't rely on someone. So what do they do is, last year I had a student, when he was revising certain subjects, he only came up with the idea to me, so that when I am revising, what I am doing is, I am taking problems from different subjects, collecting them and then solving them in a particular time frame in order to revise multiple subjects at once. It was his idea. It was his initiative. It was his thinking. So he did not rely upon me. Okay. He did not ask me to provide him certain questions, certain practice set, or tell him how he should try. So that is what makes a good student, that you must be willing to take up the mantle of your own preparation. You must be willing to put your efforts rather than always going to someone and asking for help. Okay. Because if you are always asking for help, then you basically are used to getting help whenever you are in trouble. So when you will be facing examination, then there might be certain questions which might not be in your range, but you will be used to getting help from others. In that case, there will be no one to help you and you will feel helpless and you will lack confidence. So that is what I am talking about. If you want to do something, if you want to have a test containing multiple subjects, if you want to have a daily practice session, if you want to have a time-bound practice session, you can create all this stuff by yourself. Like, when I was preparing for GATE 2013, in which I got AIR 8, I joined one test series, okay? And at that time, in that test series, only 3 mock tests were there. But as you can understand, 3 mock tests are not sufficient to get a good rank in GATE, right? So what I did is, instead of researching which other test series are there, instead of investing more money, what I did is, I downloaded GATE previous year papers and I attempted them as mock test. So what did I do in that process? That I created an obstacle for myself and I overcame that obstacle by myself. And in that process, I gained knowledge, I gained confidence, I gained all of it without relying on someone else's help. So that should be the attitude. If you face a difficulty, first try and figure out what best you can do at your own level, because once you have a habit of solving your own problems, once you have a habit of taking your preparation into your own hands, then you will never need any help and you can overcome problems very easily. Okay. So that is how, if ever you face any difficulty, first try it solving by your own. If you are not able to tackle that on your own, then only seek the help. But never ever never ever feel helpless that you will not be able to do something just because you don't have the required content, you don't have the required material. There is so much of material and so much of content available today for free that you can generate your own practice test or your own practice questions, your own practice session, anything you can do. Just you have to be bold, just you have to decide for yourself that yes, I want to do it and I'll do it my way. Okay, remember always one thing is there, that there is no fixed path to success. There is not a single method to get a good rank in GATE exam. Every aspirant has a different technique. Every aspirant has a different thought process. So since there are too many paths, you have to choose your own path and you must be willing to walk upon that path without looking back, without doubting yourself. And once you are able to do that, then you can succeed by your own method. Okay. But whenever you feel that there is a need for any sort of content, you can go and create it yourself rather than waiting for someone else to provide you with that. Okay. Like what you guys can do is, let me tell you, suppose you are facing a non-core subject which is common in electrical and DC. Okay. So what you can do is, whenever you want to revise certain subject which is common in electrical and DC, if you are an electrical GATE aspirant, what you can do is, you can open ECE previous year book and select certain chapters like chapter 1 of network analysis, chapter 2 of signals and system, chapter 1 of electrical, chapter 1 of control system, like that. Select certain chapters and then solve previous year problem from 2016 to 2019. Just count the number of problems and then start to solve them. Because when you count the number of problems, you can set a timer for yourself. Okay. So what I am saying is, suppose I take chapter 1, network basics. Okay. I take basics of network, chapter 2 of signal, let us say LTI system, and chapter 3 from control system, let us say I am taking root locus. And I have decided that from previous year ECE, I will solve problems from, let us say, 2017 to 2019. Now suppose it has 10 problems in that duration. Okay. It has, let us say, 5 problems. It has, let us say, 7 problems. So how many problems have I collected? 22 problems. I will keep 1 hour for these problems and then I have basically created a test for myself containing 22 problems with a time limit of 1 hour. Okay. So also you can add like 2-3 chapters of network, like 2-3 chapters of signals. You can do that. So that way you are creating obstacles for yourself. Obstacle how? That is, I want to achieve this feat in which I am able to solve 22 problems from 3 subjects in a single hour. If I am able to do that, then that means I am good at these things. So that way you can keep on increasing the number of subjects. Like you can increase it to 5 or 6 subjects. You can increase the number of problems to 60. You can increase the time to 3 hours. So that way, keep on testing yourself, keep on creating new opportunities, keep on creating new methods of testing yourself, and once you do that, you don't need any sort of help from my side, from any test series or anything. You can design a test series on your own. You can design it as flexibly as your schedule. Okay. So that way your money will not be wasted, as well as you will be creating tests for yourself based on your own level, based on your own thinking. How much knowledge do you have? Which chapters have you prepared? You can test yourself on that basis. Okay. But here, one thing that you need to take care is, you need to be honest with yourself. Okay. Like this 1 hour should be strictly 1 hour. It should not be even 1 hour, 1 minute. And you should check the solutions or the answers after attempting all the problems or after the completion of 1 hour. Okay. So after 1 hour only, I will check the solution. I will check how many answers or how many of my answers are correct. But before that, there is no cheat code. There is no looking back at the solution. There should be no such stuff. If you are serious enough, if you can control yourself in that manner, then definitely you are bound to reach up to greater heights. But for that, this discipline, this self-discipline should be very high. You should not basically fail yourself. You should not cheat in this. If you can do that, then you don't need any help. But if you need hand-holding, like I must tell you that don't cheat in the examination, do this examination in a proper manner, that means you are yourself not motivated enough to take your preparation into your own hands. Always remember one thing, that the biggest stake in your exam preparation is yours only. Okay, you have the biggest stake, you have taken the biggest risk. So the effort, your effort should also be the highest effort. Okay, if you are at the highest risk, your effort should also be highest. Don't expect that others should put more effort than you in your own preparation when you yourself can't push that much effort. Okay, so try and be self-dependent for certain things, so that even if someone is providing, you don't have to invest money, you don't have to wait for that person, you can create content for your own self. Okay, and you can also follow IN previous year. So content is, a lot of content is there in the market itself. You just need to go out, grab that content and use it in a proper manner. Okay. So let me know your experience. If you try doing this, how was your experience and how successful is my idea of telling you that you can do this. Okay. Because it feels very good when you guys give feedback, whether or not what I told you helped you or not. If you tell me, it will also motivate me to tell you more about preparation and stuff. So, दोबारे से बोल रहा हूँ, it will also motivate me वाली लाइन से. It will also motivate me to tell you about how you can prepare. If you give me your honest feedback, in what way have I helped you in preparation by this video. Okay, so do let me know if this technique works for you. If not, if you have certain other ideas, do let me know that so that I can share it with the student community. Thank you.